I'm gonna teach you how to do a shrink wrap basket on your own. In this basket, I have several little things, lotions, things like that. So if you want to shrink wrap a basket, I suggest adding tissue at the bottom, which I did. You may have some big things in here, and you might have some little things in here like these. And you don't want these, if you really want these to show and stand out, simply add some tape, which is what I used, is clear tape like this. And I make a little circle tape. And I simply stick it onto a large item so it can stand out. Add a little more tape, let's say, for this little basket, which is a girly basket. Say this is the chapstick, and you'll add, there's confetti in here. Tape on the back, and if you want it to stand out, simply tape it to the larger things so it can stand out. On the lotion, I have the same tape at the bottom, so it stays still in the center. These little things here are also taped. Let's say you have this little lotion and you want it to show out. Add a little bit of tape on the top and just simply tape it to the larger item so it stands out. And you have cute little things to stand out that show when you shrink wrap. Now, when you do your shrink wrapping, make sure you have a blow dryer, confetti for little accents, which I simply put a little bit of confetti for decorations and just drip it in the inside, and curling ribbon to add little decor, which is what I did here. If you need to learn how to do curling ribbon, you simply grab a ribbon, pair of scissors, hold the ribbon to the scissors, not on the sharp end, and hold with your thumb and reach out and it'll curl it. Just like this blue one, reach out, curl it fast, and it'll curl pretty little ribbons. But be sure to not use the sharp end and use your thumb to hold them, and it makes nice little accents. Now the tricky part now is the shrink wrap. Be sure to have enough shrink wrap to cover the entire item. In this case, it's about maybe 3 feet. Center the basket right in the middle of it. You'll have uneven spots, so the spot that you want to really stand out, you be sure that it has the longer spot because shrink wrap is not even. Lightly fold it up. Now the uneven part of the shrink wrap, you want to bring it in first and hold it on the top. And then bring the rest of it together evenly on each end. Just like that. Now it'll be wrinkled on the inside, so you bring the inside in so the clear part shows out better. When you have the shrink wrap, to be sure that it's even and not have parts that stick out like that, stick the uneven part inside and the larger part, circle it around so everything stays on the inside. You'll need to have a good strong rubber band. Where's my rubber band? To hold it on top, and that's very key. Use one or two, and in this case I'm using small white rubber band. Circling it around to make it easy. Twist. And then add the rubber band nice and tight, but be sure not to pull it so it doesn't break. And in this case it broke, so we'll try another one. Smaller rubber bands are hard to use because they break easy. But it doesn't have to be tight because we're going to use a ribbon to tighten it. So right now you have there. You'll grab some ribbon, as much as you want, because you'll curl it. And in this case, I'm going to use double. And what I'm going to do is double side it. Tie around the bag, and this will help to tighten it. I'll do a double knot to make sure it stays. And then you have your ribbon. Cut this end off, and like I said, with the scissors, in this case, this ribbon's shiny. So use the soft end of the scissors with your thumb and pull up and it curls. So I'm doing four of them. So you can see better. Using my thumb, curling the ribbons and making sure they're even. This case is for my niece, so I'm going to add a pretty rubber band that has decoration, and it's actually a ponytail. So I'm going to wrap it around it, a double knot, to just add extra decoration to it. See? Now this top part here is uneven. Use your scissors to cut it even so it looks nice on top. So your bag is loose and it's nice and covered up all together. Now what we're going to do now is the blow dryer part. You'll use your blow dryer on high. And key is to start at the bottom blowing, and then you blow evenly all around, and then you take your time on each section to make sure that it's nice and tight and melts just right. Never blow too hard on one section, or you can either blow a hole in it, or the basket itself will blow through. So give me a second and I'll show you how to do this. It's on high. Bottom first. Keep the blow dryer close. Keep the blow dryer closed, but never too much on each end.